Hi students, today we are going to learn about the clippers, that is second unit. First name it is linear wave shaping, second unit name is non-linear wave shaping. In this non-linear wave shaping, it contains the two parts, they are clippers and clampers. In the second unit, we have the different types of topics. They are clippers and clampers. First, we will go to learn the clippers. What is meant by clipper? Clipper, which is used to remove the unwanted part of the signal with respect to DC level. Once again, what is the definition of the clipper means? Clipper, it is a circuit which is used to remove the unwanted part of the signal with respect to the DC waveform, that is known as a clipper. Clipper have the different types of, they are positive clippers and negative clippers. So what is the definition of the clipper? Clipper is a circuit which is used to remove the unwanted part of the signal, and the clipper is also called as selectors, slicers and voltage limiters. These are all the other names for the clippers. Clipper mainly which is used in the TV circuits, wave shaping circuits, sawtooth generators, TV remotes, radio receivers, TV transmitters, TV receivers. These are all the applications of the clippers. So now we are learn the different types of clippers. Clipper which consisting of the different configurations, they are according to nonlinear devices, according to biasing. According to the nonlinear devices, the clippers can be classified into diode clippers and transistor clippers. According to the biasing, the clippers can be classified into unbiased clippers and biased clippers. Classification of clippers are important. So according to the nonlinear devices, that is nonlinear devices are diode clippers and transistor clippers. According to the biasing, the clippers may be classified into unbiased clippers and biased clippers. Now we will see the according to the configuration, the clippers may be classified into different types. According to the configuration, the clippers may be classified into series diode clippers, shunt diode clippers, combination of diode clippers. According to the level of clipping, clippers may be classified into positive clippers, negative clippers, biased clippers and combination of clippers. These clippers are very important, that is according to level of clipping, the clippers may be positive clippers, negative clippers, biased clippers and combination of clippers. Now we will see the positive clippers. Positive clipper and negative clipper. In this positive clipper, it has two types. They are positive series clipper and positive shunt clipper. Positive diode clippers, which are classified into two types. They are positive series clipper and positive shunt clipper. Now we will see the positive series clipper. This is the circuit diagram of the positive series clipper. This is the circuit diagram. We are taking the one diode, that is which is connected to the reverse to the resistor, the diode PN junction diode which is connected in reverse and which is connected to in series to the load resistor. Here, what is the purpose of load resistor means, at the output side, if any loading effects are occur, these loadings are reduced by the load resistor. So this is the positive series clipper. Why we are called as positive series clipper means the diode which is connected to the in series to the load. So that's why it is the series clipper. What is the operation of the positive series clipper? What I said is clipper means clipper, which is used to remove the unwanted part of the signal. Clipper means which is used to remove the unwanted part of the signal. Here, what is the unwanted part means? Positive series, positive signal is the unwanted signal. So it has to remove the positive half cycle. But we are giving the full cycle input, but output is only negative cycle. How it is reducing the positive half cycle means, let us see. First of all, we are taking the one input signal, that is the full input waveform, that is the full cycle of the input waveform. So first we will take the first positive half cycle. Now we are considering the only positive half cycle only. During the positive half cycle, the diode which is connected in reverse bias to the load resistor. During the positive half cycle, the diode which is in reverse bias condition. In reverse bias condition, the diode does not work because it is in the reverse bias condition. So there is no input which is passed to the output. That means here the output voltage which does not pass to the output. In this, we are considering the positive half cycle. During the positive half cycle, the diode which is in reverse bias condition, it can be act as a open switch. So all the voltage which is dropped across the only diode, So the positive half cycle is reduced. It does not pass to the output. So output is zero. Vi is equal to Vm, but Vout is equal to zero. Vout is equal to zero. During the positive half cycle, diode in reverse bias condition. So it is in reverse bias condition. It does not pass any input cycle to the output. So it is which is acting as a open switch. So the positive half cycle is reduced. In this, Vout is equal to zero. Let us consider the negative half cycle. During the negative half cycle, diode goes to the reverse forward bias condition. So in forward bias condition, diode is conducts and all the input voltage which is passed to the output. In this condition, Vout is equal to minus Vm. Why? Because of during the negative half cycle, diode is in forward bias condition, which is acting as a open switch. All the input voltage which is passed to the output. There is no voltage drop across the load resistor. So all the input which is passed to the output, that is Vout is equal to minus Vm. This is the operation of the positive series diode clipper. Once again, I am telling the operation of the positive series diode clipper means, first of all, we have to consider the one input signal. So that is one positive cycle, and another one is one negative half cycle, positive and negative cycle. First of all, we are considering the positive half. During the positive half cycle, diode is in reverse bias condition. So in reverse bias condition, it does not conduct and it can be acting as a open switch. So all the output voltage is zero. That means in this condition, Vout is equal to zero during the positive half cycle. Now we are considering the negative half cycle. During the negative half cycle, diode goes to the forward bias condition. And which is acting as a closed switch, and all the input which is passed to the output. So in this condition, Vout is equal to minus Vm. V out is equal to minus Vm. This is the operation of the positive series clipper. This is the output. Positive series means positive half cycle has to remove. What is the output of the positive series clipper means? Only negative cycle will be appear at the output because of the positive cycle has to remove. Because of the positive series clipper. Clipper means it has to remove the unwanted. What is the unwanted part here is positive cycle. So the unwanted part is removed. Now let us see the another topic, that is positive shunt clipper. Positive shunt clipper. This is the positive shunt clipper circuit diagram. That means the diode which is connected in shunt to the load resistor. The diode which is connected in shunt to the load resistor. So let us consider the one input cycle. This is full half cycle input. Let us see the operation. During the positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias condition. During the positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias condition. In this forward bias condition, which is acting as a closed switch, and all the input it is passed to the output, but there is a voltage drop across the diode. There is a voltage drop across the diode, so that output is zero. V out is equal to zero. That means positive cycle is zero. Let us consider the another half cycle, that is negative half cycle. During the negative half cycle, the diode goes to the reverse bias condition. In reverse bias condition, the diode does not conduct. That means it can be acting as a open switch. So all the input which is passed to the output, but there is no voltage drop across the diode, so all the input which is passed to the diode, so that the output will be appear. That is, in this condition, V out is equal to minus Vm. V out is equal to minus Vm. V out is equal to minus Vm. This is the operation of the positive shunt clipper. Once again, I am telling the operation of the positive shunt clipper means the diode has to connect, diode has to connect in shunt to the load resistor. First of all, have to take the one input signal, that is full cycle. So let us consider the positive half cycle. During the positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias condition. Diode conducts, which is acting as a closed switch, but there is a voltage drop across the diode. Due to that, there is no output voltage across the output. So output V out is equal to zero. V out is equal to zero. Once again, we are considering the negative half cycle. In this condition, diode is in reverse bias condition. So it does not conduct, but there is no voltage drop across the diode, so all the input which is passed to the output. In this condition, output V out is equal to minus Vm. V out is equal to minus Vm. This is the operation of the positive shunt clipper. Positive shunt clipper means it has to get the output is only negative because of the positive cycle has to remove. So the positive clippers, which are classified into two types, they are positive series clipper and positive shunt clipper. This is the operation of the positive clippers. Now we will see the negative clippers. These are all the circuit diagrams under the two cases, that is during the positive half cycle and during the negative half cycle. Let us see the negative diode clippers. These negative diode clippers are also classified into two types. They are negative series clipper and negative shunt clipper. In positive clipper, what is the unwanted part is positive peak. Now What is the unwanted part in negative clipper means? Negative part is the unwanted part. So negative cycle has to remove. So the output only at the positive side only. So let us see the operations of the positive negative series clippers and negative shunt clippers. Negative series clipper and negative shunt clipper. Let us see the positive series clipper. Let us consider the one circuit diagram. This is the circuit diagram of the negative series clipper. We are connecting the diode in series to the load resistor. So let us considering the one input signal, that is full half cycle. The full input signal during the negative half cycle, during the positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias condition. In forward bias condition, which is acting as a open circuit, closed switch, and all the input which is passed to the load resistor. So output Vout is equal to Vm. Vout is equal to Vm. During the positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias condition. And it can be acting as a closed switch. So all the input which is passed to the output. So in this condition, Vout is equal to Vm. Let us consider the another half cycle, that is negative half cycle. In this condition, diode goes to the reverse bias condition. In this reverse bias condition, diode does not conduct. So there is no output voltage across the diode. So that output is zero. Vout is equal to zero. Once again, I am telling the operation of the negative series clipper. First of all, you have to consider the one circuit diagram. We are taking the one diode and one resistor. The diode which is connected in series to the load resistor. So this is the circuit diagram. First of all, we are considering the one input signal. Let us see operation. During the positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias condition. So in this condition, diode conducts and it can be acting as a closed switch. All the input which is passed to the output. So that output is Vout is equal to Vm. Again, we are considering the negative half cycle, and in this condition, diode goes to the reverse bias condition. In this condition, the diode does not conduct, and it can be acting as a open switch. So the output is zero. Vout is equal to zero. This is the output waveform of the negative series clipper. Let us see the another topic, that is negative shunt clipper. In negative shunt clipper, diode has to conduct in shunt to the load resistor. This is the circuit diagram of the negative shunt clipper. First of all, we are considering the one input signal, that is full cycle. Let us consider one positive half cycle, which is given to the load resistor, and it is applied to the diode. Diode is in reverse bias condition. In this, during the positive half cycle, diode is in reverse bias condition. In reverse bias condition, diode does not conduct, but there is no voltage drop across the diode. So all the input which is passed to the output, so that is output is positive. And let us consider the negative half cycle. In this condition, diode goes to the forward bias condition and it conducts. It produces the output voltage, but there is a voltage drop across the load resistor, so that output is zero. During the positive half cycle, output Vout is equal to Vm, because of the, even though diode is in reverse bias condition, but there is a voltage drop across the diode, so that the output voltage Vout is equal to Vm. And again we are considering the negative half cycle. It is in reverse bias condition, sorry, it goes to the forward bias condition. Diode conduct, but there is a voltage drop across the diode, so due to that Vout is equal to zero. Vout is equal to zero. The output waveform for the negative diode clipper is only positive half cycle. In negative clipper, what is the output is only positive half. In series positive clipper, what is the output is negative, only negative. Positive half cycle has to clipper. So this is the operation of the negative clippers, positive and negative clippers. And we will see the another topic. These are all the circuit diagrams when you are considering the during the positive half cycle, which is in forward bias condition, during the negative half cycle, which is in reverse bias condition. These are all the circuit diagrams of the positive and negative clippers. Let us see the another topic, that is biased positive clipper and biased negative clipper. These are the different from the positive clippers and negative clippers. In negative clipper, only negative peak is clipped. In positive clipper, only positive peak is clipped. So in this condition, biased means it has to cut the some reference voltage only. That means if you are keeping the reference voltage at 5 volts, input is at 6 volts. That means only the output waveform is at 5 volts only. Remaining 1 volt is clipped off. That is the biased. So biased clippers, which may be classified into two types. They are biased positive clipper and biased negative clipper. We will see the biased positive clipper. Biased positive clipper means only positive side it has to clip some voltage. Some reference voltage has to clipped off in the positive half cycle only. Let us see the operation. We are considering the circuit diagram, that is we are taking the one resistor. We are taking the one resistor and diode, which is connected in reverse bias condition, and we are adding the reference voltage, that is Vr. We are adding the one reference voltage, that is Vr. This is RL, output voltage. This is the circuit diagram of the positive biased clipper. Positive biased clipper. So this is the circuit diagram. What is the operation of the positive biased clipper? Means we are taking the one input signal, which is applied to the resistor, from the resistor, which is connected to the diode. Diode is in which condition? That is in forward bias condition. So suppose we are keeping the reference voltage at Vr is equal to 5 volts. Input is at Vi is equal to 6 volts. Input is at Vi is equal to 6 volts. Vr is equal to 5 volts. So we are considering the positive half cycle. In this condition, diode is in forward bias condition, and it is in forward bias condition, which can be acting as a closed switch, and all the input which is passed to the reference voltage Vr, which is from the diode, which is passed to the reference voltage. The reference voltage, which is fixed at what voltage? 5 volts. So only 5 volts will get the output, remaining 1 volt will be clipped off. Why? Because of we are fixed at the reference voltage, battery voltage, which is fixed at the only 5 volts. So input voltage, which is greater than the reference voltage. So the 1 volt is will be clipped off. 1 volt will be clipped off. Only we are getting the 5 volts output. That means like this. Suppose we are taking the input voltage is at 6 volts. 6 volts. That means only reference voltage which we fixed at the 5 volts. That the input which can be like this. Only it will get the, that means only 5 volts. our output voltage will get the only 5 amp. Remaining 1 volt will be clipped off. That is the biasing. At what cycle it will be clipped off means during the positive half cycle. The diode is in forward bias condition. The reference voltage, which is fixed at the 5 volts. So input is greater than the output. That means remaining 1 volt will be clipped off. Only 5 volts will be get the output. Now let us consider the negative half cycle. In this condition, diode is in, diode goes to the reverse bias condition, and which can be act as a open switch, and it is passed to the reference voltage. So the all the input voltage which is passed to the output, so output will get the same as the input voltage. This is the operation of the positive bias clipper. Once again, I am explaining the positive bias clipper. First of all, you have to consider the one circuit diagram. So, and we have to consider the one reference voltage, that is VR. We are taking the one resistor and diode and reference voltage. This is the circuit diagram. Now we are considering the one input signal. So output will get the like this. How it is getting the like this means, first of all, we are considering the one positive half cycle. In this condition, diode is in forward bias condition, which can be act as a closed switch, and it is passed to the reference voltage. The reference voltage fixed at the sum voltage, which is input is greater than the reference voltage. So input is greater than the reference voltage. Suppose assuming the VI is equal to 6 volts, VR is equal to 5 volts. VR, which is fixed at the 5 volts. That means 1 volt has to be clipped off because of the input voltage, which is greater than the reference voltage. Reference voltage is only 5 volts. In this condition, 1 voltage will be clipped. The output will be like this. This is the input, 6 volts. But reference voltage, which is fixed at what voltage? 5 volts. Only 5 volts will be get the output. This is the output. That means at reference voltage only output will be get above the above voltage will be clipped off. The remaining output input voltage will be clipped off. This is the output waveform. Let us consider the another negative half cycle. During the negative half cycle, diode goes to the reverse bias condition, which does not conduct and can be acting as a open switch. So all the input which is passed to the output, so output will get the negative half cycle. This is the output waveform of the positive bias clipper. So we discussed about the positive clippers, positive series clipper and positive shunt clipper. Negative clippers, negative series clipper and negative shunt clipper. Again, positive biased clipper. The remaining topics will be discussed in the next session. The clippers units is very easy. If you can concentrate on this unit, it will get the maximum marks. So if you refer once after the class, we have to refer the notes. I will provide the full material. from 1st unit to 6th unit. So if you have any doubts, you can contact me. So in the next section, I will discuss the remaining units.